And now let's create all the noises. And dive inside. This node setup is gonna be a bit messy, but it's actually not so much different nodes. It's just copied nodes over and over again. To deform our geometry, we'll mainly use the unified noise static. Don't use this noise, use the static. This one is way slower. So use the static and put in the position down here. Now we can already take this into color and set it to noise. Let's promote the frequency. And actually this yellow input is a vector 4, but we don't need the last one, so let's just convert it back to a 3 float. And this is gonna convert back to a vector 4, so it doesn't make a difference. Now here, we can just increase the frequency. And now we will use the Worley cellular F1. So we will actually use one base frequency. Let's put this now to, let's say 40. And then we will multiply this frequency for each of the noises we copy down. So in this case, let's decrease this down to 0.08 to get really large patterns. We will use this pattern now and multiply it by a parameter to later change the effect of this noise. Let's rename this to level 1 Worley and just set it to 0.5 for default. Then let's add a displace along normal. Use this as the amount and set it to position. Now let's play around with the scale. You can now see these rock-like patterns. Let's just decrease this for now. This will be our final scale for every value we add. So let's push this over here, this over here. Now let's copy this noise. So this is the first noise. Now copy it and replace this. We will use the same position, but this time use a other multiply constant. We will use a value of 0.3 to get smaller patches. And now with a multiply and promoting this value, we can now say level 2 Worley. Also 0.5 at default. We actually want one more unified noise that is in with this frequency. For now, let's just clap in those inputs because we don't need them. And copy this node. Or let's say these three. We will use the same frequency. Let's just put all these positions with Alt to one string and set this to F2 minus F1. Now when we replace it with this, we get this shape. This time we don't want the same input, so let's change this to 0.2 Worley. So it isn't the same. And it's actually the same, just a different version. And then again, let's duplicate this one for the level 3 whirly, which will be the smallest whirly. This one will have a multiply constant of 0.6. Now let's visualize this. Alright, now to add all of them, we will use a add. Select everything and then put it in here. Put this into the amount. And now with the final scale, we can scale everything down. Now we will also create an offset value for all of these. So let's just promote the offset. Put it also in here. We will actually use the offset for all of the values, because if they are not the same frequency, you can't really tell if they are the same offset. Only for these two, because they use the same frequency, we will add constant, just a value of whatever. We'll also set this to 3 float. Now we can just offset this. Now we want to add a parameter to control how much it influences the interior. So if the interior is, for example, right here, we want the noise to affect more, for example. So for this, we will use the attribute interior. So let's just bind import this. And use this before the multiply to edit to our original parameter. And to control the amount, we will use a multiply, promote this, and say whirly 1 interior fluence. Now we will copy this, paste it in here. Replace this, call this one now whirly 2 interior influence, and also this, copy it again down here, put this right there in, replace this, rename this to 2.5. And paste it down here as well. This time level 3. Now we got the interior influence. Test it by saying level 3. Increase this. And now you can see this is the slight interior side, and this was the area. Now when we increase it, you can only see those areas be affected even more. Now we will pre-distort our mesh. For this we will use a distortion down here before we feed it into the noise. We will use an anti-flow noise and add this to our current position. It's just a distortion. For visualization, we will just input this directly in a new position. Now we can say increase the frequency, reduce the amplitude. Now we will have this distortion. So the frequency we'll use for this is the real frequency without a multiply constant. And the offset will also be just the offset. Let's set the amplitude to something really low, like 0.02, and the roughness slightly less, 0.4. And now let's drag this into a network box and put it in here. Now put this position again in a position. Now we will create three noises, one noise for this, and one for this. We will not use it on the biggest noise. Those noises will be used to act as a mask. So set the position to this position, set the frequency to this frequency, 0.3, and add just another multiply constant by 0.5. So we will have 0.15. We will fit this now between 0.05, 0.03, just to clamp every side a bit, and later promote this destination min to again use it as the influence of the mask. So we'll take this and put it into the second multiply right here. Let's also just visualize this mask in the color. Alright, now in the white areas, the noise will be visible, on the black not. Now let's copy this noise. And this time we want to control the second valley noise too. So let's now put this in here. This time we will just use another offset. The frequency will be the same. So let's get the offset. Put this in here. And in here, use a add constant to just offset the offset. Let's just put a random number and a random number in here. So even that we have the same noise with a different offset, now it will be different. For the fit, let's promote the destination min and just call this mask minimum. And also put this in this destination minimum and hide inputs again. Now let's copy this noise one more time for the detailed noise. This time we will use the 0.3 frequency without the multiply constant. So let's take this and put it in here. And the offset should just be this. Maybe you could also just create an add constant. Right, now let's put this in here. And let's just clean up everything a bit. So we will have our mask right here. Then we will have the detailed noise, the second mid detail, and the first mid detail, and the low frequency noise. This is the frequency. We can just hide this. Let's just say on this note, hide input. Now everyone will have the same parameter. When we unfolded it, it's still the same. And maybe move this up a bit and also hide the offset. We can close the mask now. Put this over here. We will add one more feature, which we will add after the displays along the normal. This will be a final distortion with a bigger noise for the whole geometry. For this, let's also use an anti-flow noise. Put the position in here. Set the frequency to the frequency. And just visualize this. We will add a add right here to just add this noise to our current position. Currently it's still a 1D noise, so let's put it to 3D. Let's decrease the amplitude and multiply this also by the interior. So normally this distortion should only be visible on the interior parts, but we can also just fit this to say how much we want it everywhere. For this, let's promote the destination minimum and call it distortion everywhere. So now if the interior is 1, for example, and here 0, now we can just shift the 0 value up by, let's say, 0.1. So we'll have a 0.1 effect of distortion everywhere and a 1 value of distortion on the interior parts. Now let's look at all those parameters and how we can control them. Let's first of all change the order of the parameters. So we want our base frequency, which every frequency is dependent on, at the top. Then we want the offset, then the initial distortion. Let's see if we have promoted it. Let's also promote the amplitude and the roughness of the initial distortion and call it initial amplitude and initial roughness. Now let's put this at the beginning, just after the frequency and after the offset. Then let's add a separator after this. And now we will have the whirly noise from level 1 to level 3. We will first use the level 1 whirly, then the level 1 interior influence, level 2 whirly, Level 2 interior influence, level 2.5 whirly, and the interior influence, 3 and 3 interior influence. The mask minimum and distortion everywhere will be afterwards. Let's also add a separator in here. Let's also promote the amplitude of the distortion. So now we'll have a overall distortion scale on the whole mesh, and then how much it also should affect the whole geometry. Let's call this distortion amplitude. Then we will have the distortion everywhere, and we also want the final scale. So with this scale we will scale each of them up or down. And now let's also edit this. So we'll have the final scale, the distortion amplitude, distortion everywhere, mask, and the final scale will be in here. Let's see how this looks. So the final scale should be between 0 and 1. Now let's test it. Let's just decrease the distortion amplitude and the initial amplitude. Now the first thing will be the first level whirly. So let's just increase this, and we can already see those patterns. Now the interior influence would be in here. We would do just the extra scale in here, but we don't really need it. Now the level 2. We can already see the effect of the mask. Let's try the interior. Alright, then the second whirly 2 noise. When we increase this, we have a different pattern. Was a different mask, something like that. Try it on the interior parts and the final detail noise. Let's actually increase the frequency a bit to 50 maybe. Try the detail noise on the interior parts. Now let's reduce the final scale. You could also just say frequency on the Y. Yeah. So that you have the stretch look. Now we can control the minimum for the mask. When we set it to 1, the mask will have no effect. So now it's really uniform. But when we decrease this, now we'll have a more random pattern. Now let's add the initial distortion. So before we add the noises to break up these edges, increase this slightly. Yeah, way more detail. And play around with the roughness, no roughness, and a lot of roughness. Four. And then we'll have one final distortion. So when we just increase this, and say distortion everywhere should be 1. Now it will affect everything. Now it will only affect the interior parts. Let's actually decrease the roughness of this a bit to 0.3 or 0.4. You could additionally use the interior attribute to mask out that the mask should not have an effect on the interior parts as much as on the rest, but we will keep it for now like this.